My name is Katherine Anderson. This is my husband, Nate. We live in Chicago, and we have a son who's 3 years old, almost four, whose name is Benjamin. And we also have a son who would be six, whose name is Joey.
We both got married a little older in life, and we waited about a year to start trying to have kids after we had a nice honeymoon. And super excited to start our family. And we got pregnant actually fairly quickly after trying, and everything was going great. We went in for a 20-week ultrasound, which was like a higher level ultrasound, I think a level two at that point, right? Which is more in depth. And I had brought to the hospital, I had brought one bag of goodies for a boy and one bag of goodies for a girl. And so I was going to pull out whichever one. We were going to find out the gender that day. We did find out the gender and found out that Joey was a boy. After the ultrasound tech said, I'm going to leave the room. I'm going to go bring in the doctor. And Catherine kind of looked at me. I didn't know what that meant. It was our first time. And the kind of one of the head doctors came in and started to just had a look on her face that was gloom, downcast, and very, you know,
somber.
Yeah, somber. And Catherine knew right away. Her instincts kicked in. I didn't really know what it meant, but I will never forget the look on the doctor's face, mixed with what then came out of her mouth, which I don't remember everything that came out, because I remember looking at her face more so than the words. But ultimately, that your child, baby boy, has a condition called holoprosencephaly. And what the imaging is showing is that it's alobar, which means it's the worst kind of holoprosencephaly. And what that means is basically his brain did not form appropriately in utero. And he maybe had 10 or 20% of brain matter. The rest of his brain was just fluid and hollow. So that was a shock. She knew more than I did. I didn't really understand what it really meant. I wanted to go to, you know, start researching. But it was a brutal diagnosis, and we knew it was not good at the moment, but we didn't know what all it translated to. I'll pause and let you kick in from there.
I don't know that I knew more until we did start researching, but I heard fatal, yeah. Fatal diagnosis and terminal diagnosis, and knew that we may never meet him.
Yeah.
But we were able to. We were able to meet him. So that catapulted us into a lot of appointments, being moved from a midwife to the high-risk specialists, and meeting with a palliative care team that would take care of Joey potentially after he was born, a neonatal palliative care team.